freedom. Fire in my soul, fire in my heart, till you see me on the other side of stars.
Warning advisory. This movie contains the following, such as strong language, slightly sexual themes, slut shaming, arguments, somewhat poorly animated scenes, a few errors made along the way, pedophilia jokes and references, a few mentions of suicide, but the characters don't really kill themselves, and aesthetic warnings. If you're not over 18 and older, then I advise you to not watch this movie. However, if you don't mind, then don't make me say that I warned you. Anyways, enjoy the movie or don't or whatever. I don't care.
And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Yay!
Shut the fuck up, Codename. No one cares. Now then, on with the movie.
Ahem, everyone.
Yes?
Oh, yes, sir?
I want you to give me full reports and details on our games. Start with Persona 3 Reload.
Oh, of course, sir. Everyone seems to love the most recent trailer and update so far. They're just itching themselves to wait several months until it releases.
Yeah, but would it be better to try and make the pre-orders of the game have an early access starting on January 31st, 2024?
Maybe. Good point there.
That sounds like a plan. Maybe we should re-release the same game two times with the answer epilogue episode in one version and the female character route in the next.
Whoa, what the fuck?
Wait, why would you say that? How about we release them both as DLC? We just need to charge our players a bit more money for that, and it can be fair.
That sounds acceptable.
Aw, man, it's too much work.
Look, you've all shared some incredible ideas for the future of our game, but why the fuck would you bring that horrible mistake of a protagonist in as DLC?
Well, I...
Don't give me that excuse, employee number three. You know damn well that she is a pedophile. Oh, and her story is also non-canon, so you can't really let this become green-lit. We are focusing on the main male protagonist, and not her.
Hey, what's your problem with the female protagonist? Didn't we slightly change the dialogue in the Persona 3 portable re-release to not make an awkward romantic relationship with her and Kanemata?
He has a point there. But if we include both the answer episode and the female protagonist storyline as DLC, I believe more people are going to praise us. Boss, I think 3 has a point with his ideas for the game, so...
We'll get a lot of revenue from the game's success throughout the entirety of next year. What if we also took the time to completely try to revamp the other two games, 4 and 5? I heard rumors online that there could be an alternate ending in our remake where the protagonist doesn't commit the deathy, methy sleep in the end. And it could lead up to a new storyline of games where he's with his friends.
Can we do the same with the female protagonist too?
What? Why? What the fuck is wrong with you? All of you?
But sir...
You really want to break the Sacred Atlas tradition? We released the original game at full price without the answer, and portable storylines first. Then once that's done, we plan to re-release the same game with the add-ons, so we can milk Persona 3 as much as we milk Persona 5 itself. I mean, look how much more popular it is apart from Persona 3. I know we can't compete with the other popular games this year such as Starfield, Baldur's Gate 3, Spider-Man 2, Tears of the Kingdom, Jedi Survivor, Super Mario Bros. Wonder, etc., etc., and etc. 2024 is going to be our biggest year for Persona 3 Reload, and it will take the world by storm first as the most successful game of the year. Our money-grubbing weeaboo fandom is going to go high over heels and apeshit over our game. So we stick with tradition first.
Damn, that sucks ass.
Why release the game two or three different times when we should release it with everything in it all at once? What about the definitive edition?
Why did I even hire you dumb fucks in the first place?
I'm just here to support the wife and kids. Nothing usual.
Well, you're not doing a damn good job about it, dumbass.
All this because I mentioned FemC.
Okay, what the hell was that?
I don't know. Was it one of our own?
Let's go check it out.
You first.
All of you are such pussies. Follow me. We made it, boys. Now stop shitting yourselves already and pull it together. We're in the secret vault of our headquarters. Whatever occurred here must be caused by our suspect.
Wait, sir. Do you hear that?
Hold on. Who are you?
It's me. You guys remember me from P3P? The best version of Persona 3 overall?
Oh, fuck, it's Codenay!
Yep, that's me. I just waited here the whole time until it was right to talk to you guys. So, am I gonna be in the DLC expansion pack for Persona 3 Reload? Am I?
Why the fuck would we let you in?
Oh my god! FemC-chan!
Shut the fuck up, Employee 3. Anyways, no, you're not going to be in the remake. For the last time. I swear to god if you don't stop complaining with your Laura Bailey sounding ass, I'm gonna have to kick you out by force.
Wait, what? Why? Aren't I the best thing that's happened to Persona 3 in a whole? Being a female protagonist to choose over the male protagonist that is pretty much the best option you could come up with?
No. Are you this stupid, you fucking pedophile? You know for damn sure why you're not allowed in the remake. It's your sick fantasy with Ken Amata in the game. He's literally 10 years old. Everyone's finally woke up and realized that you were grooming a minor in that game. And to be more politically correct, we had to remove you from the remake in order to cater to our money-grubbing fanbase.
But I didn't do anything wrong. Besides, I would never, ever finger a minor at all. All Ken and I did was that we just talked for hours. Definitely no sexual relations with each other happened. I never took my clothes off for him and tried to give him the sucky, fucky, gluck, gluck.
Okay, now you're just overdoing it, you copyright infringing bitch. In fact, you came here just for a particular reason to try and invade our game. And what for? So you can get your smelly-ass pedo hands on Ken again?
Aw, oh, come on, Mr. C. I'm just Ken. I still love him even if he's Ken.
Wow. That has got to be the worst way to use that song for this dumbass situation. You know what? I'm calling security. Hello? It's me, the CEO. We're in the secret vault with Codenay Shiomi. She won't stop talking shit about our game and why her sorry ass isn't in it. This is very serious, and we need a minimal amount of force to get her out of here. No rush.
Hey guys, look! Is that the priestess Shadow Arcana with BJ written on her nipples?
Okay, stop trying to make references to other videos, Yupito. That's not gonna work.
Is that Mitsuru Senpai in her bathing suit with huge bouncy tatas holding prototype copies of all of the re-releases of Persona 3 Reload close to her student council president worthy boobs?
Are you kidding me? She got away again.
Damn it, every single time. We've underestimated her from the very beginning.
I'm sorry, boss. I couldn't help it.
Ah, what in the holy heavenly testicles is going on?
Everyone who isn't busy with what they're doing at this moment must drop everything right now. Find Codenay Shiomi. Get her out of the building this instant.
What the fuck? Cupcake alarms? What about the old one?
Well, a certain someone pulled the alarm to reenact that one scene from The Office when Persona 3 Reload was officially announced. Do you know how much money it costs to replace the alarm system at all?
This is making my ears bleed harder than Kotone's cover of I'm Just Ken.
Well, I thought it was all right.
Oh my god, look outside! Is that a fucking rocket launcher?
Oh shit, 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 shit!
Well, this was the last straw. If I can't get in Persona 3 Reload, then no one else can. Goodbye and get fucked, Atlas!
Guys, can you all chill out already? I mean, my voice actor's pretty much voicing Yukari's dad, so isn't that a good thing?
Oh, yeah? Then why didn't your voice actor voice you instead? Yeah, that's right. You were too busy dicking around as Spider-Man instead. As for you, Mitsuru, you fucking spoiled rich-ass lying ass. Sorry excuse for a student council president. How did your old VA get to voice that woman in blue while you got a new voice actress? It makes no sense. None of us should have been recasted in the first place.
I don't think it's a big issue, Yukari. I think she sounds just fine like my original actress. But if you continue to keep shit-talking me over my new voice, I'm going to fucking kick you back into your stupid slut of a mother's womb where you belong. Fucking slut.
Okay, Jesus Christ. All of this whole slut-shaming thing has gotten really old. Can we talk about something else? Because if you don't, I'm gonna sonic punch both of your fucking mouths to keep you silent for the rest of the video.
Can't believe I'm saying this, but Aki has more complete sense than you two. Now then, let's talk about the game itself.
Yeah, like Chidori, you know? I'm glad that she's coming back in glorious, stunning HD and all that. Man, I feel lucky enough to be alive.
What about me?
Oh, right, I do get to hang out with you and the other members on some days. That is pretty cool.
I know, right? It's pretty exciting to get to know more about each other whenever we hang out with you at least one at a time. This is gonna be so much fun.
Did you also know you could pet Koro-chan in the new game? I think that's going to earn an instant 10 out of 10 for sure.
Okay, and? What about the fact that some stupid
Yukari! Don't you dare finish it!
Ugh, fine. As I was saying earlier, what about the fact when some idiot online said that my new model didn't look homophobic enough? I mean, seriously, do you really think I'd go that far?
Dude, you just almost fucking said that slur a moment ago, Yukari.
Oh, yeah, right.
If you had said it just now, then you would have gotten your hoe ass canceled immediately. So for the love that is all holy, stop being such a total bitch, Kari.
Excuse me, what the fuck did you just say?
Shinjiro Senpai, stop now. We don't want to get copyrighted for using the same joke over and over so many times.
Aw, come on, Makoto. You know Yucatan's been acting like a total bitch Kari this whole time.
For once, I have to agree with Iori. This problematic bitch Kari has done nothing but complain about the new game non-stop.
I hate to join in the bandwagon of referencing a certain parody series, but you are right, Mitsuru Senpai. That's what she is. Bitch Kari.
Bitch Kari, as they say. Haha, bitch Kari!
Bitch Kari! Shit, now I've gone and fucked up again.
We're gonna milk this shit until bitch fucking Kari learns to know her place. This is what she deserves after everything she's done to us.
Sigh, bitch Kari.
Haha, now you're getting it, dude.
Oh my god! I have fucking had it up to here! This is the last fucking straw! Stop fucking calling me bitch Kari!
Oh, hey there! Are we all going on a bitch Kari marathon today?
Oh fuck, it's Kami!
Stay away from me! I told you over and over that it's wrong to molest a child who isn't over the age of consent.
Can you go fuck off, Kotone? We're pretty much busy right now. Hold on a second. What's up with that face tattoo? Did you go to prison after finally admitting to be a child predator this whole time?
Well, I am... Oh, hell no. Look, everyone. I'm tired of being rejected by Atlas 24/7, so I think I should have a chance to get in the game as later DLC by myself. I don't want to be left in the dark like those other protagonists that they ignored literally just this year. Do you not realize what it's like to be in a secret vault at the headquarters of a well-known JRPG game company at all? I had everything! I had all of the potential of a new storyline, a chance in the spotlight, but then you guys all had to go and roast my ass about me being a pedophile for some reason because of Ken. So what? We're not dating. We're just friends. I just can't think of the actual reason why Atlas hates me. Do you guys hate me too?
Kotone, I don't know what to say. What I can say is that you're... Look, whatever you did out there, if you're doing what I think you're doing, then it's not gonna work. Kotone, please. I know how badly you want to get into the remake, but I don't think that'll happen yet until Atlas actually decides to make you playable in a full DLC story pack. So can you please patiently wait until they decide to do that? And if you ever get a new voice actress, I hope she also sounds as good as the original. Just give it time. Or do whatever you want, I guess. I don't care, really.
So does that mean
Just get the fuck out of here already. We'll see you whenever. Sheesh.
Fuck! You fucking fuck all of you!
Thank you.
Well, that was fucking stupid. Anyways, who wants to go to Tokyo Disneyland?
Yay!
So, that's how we ended up here enjoying our vacation. Then there's everyone
else. Splash Mountain is a log flume ride at Tokyo Disneyland. It was formerly located at Disneyland.
Oh shit, hold on!
This is such cap, bro. Such cap.
You better take your raggedy, wacky ass eyes off me and into the ride experience begins with a peaceful outdoor playthrough that leads to indoor dark ride segments with a climactic steam
ride. Will you two shut the fuck up for one fucking moment?
Hey there! Would you like to escape this vault with me?
Who the fuck are you supposed to be?
Bruh!
Kanashimi oborete
We come to you now with breaking news. Today was a tragic event that had unexpectedly occurred with the bombing of Atlas West headquarters here in Irvine, California. Just moments ago, what appears to be a 17-year-old girl with a face tattoo and a rocket launcher had destroyed the building due to controversy surrounding her alleged pedophilia crimes with one 10-year-old boy named Ken Amada. The suspect is now identified to be Kotone Shiomi from Persona 3 Portable, the female protagonist aside from the main male protagonist, Makoto Yuki. Multiple casualties were reported after the bombing, but thankfully, there were many other survivors that were able to get out safely, including the CEO of Atlas West. Now, Shiomi is on the loose, and if you're a die-hard Persona 3 Reload fan, then watch your ass. God help us all, and good night.
I mean, seriously. I know it's been since 2009 when I got my game ported to the PSP the same year as you, but why did you decide to come now to break us out?
Oh, no reason. I'm just doing it so I could give you guys a second chance to get remakes of your games so that you can earn your spotlight back again. As for me, I have my own reasons.
Your own reasons? You literally just blew up the headquarters not too long ago. What is it that you want from Atlas?
Do you want to be in a new game or something? Is that it?
Yes.
Wow, I can't believe she just straight up said that.
So, I guess this is the part where we all leave this place.
Yes. Well then, I guess we can let's stay positive, everyone.
Why the fuck do you sound like a teenager? You're literally an adult, Maya.
Don't blame me. Blame the creator of this video for being broke as shit.
Sigh, Jesus Christ.
All right, let's get out of here, everyone. Atlas Japan is up next.
Wow, Splash Mountain was exciting, I guess. Even if it's the only one standing today. Guys?
Yeah, right. I can't believe we had to change into our summer clothes after that drop. Fuck, now I'm gonna have to wash the gunk off of my uniform when we go back home.
As for me, I do not require any extra clothing for the time being, since I was entirely waterproof during the whole ride. Although, I would like to try one of the merchandise apparel in the store just on our left. Will it fit me just right, Makoto-san?
Seriously, Ai-chan, you got a bunch of clothes at home. I mean, One shirt couldn't hurt, at least.
Thank you, Junpei-san. I wholly appreciate your compliment, as it was very welcoming for me. Will you be paying for the shirt for me later?
What? I don't know.
Don't push yourself too hard, Junpei. I'll cover for her.
Ah, thank you, Makoto-san. I shall refer to you as Br'er Yuki from now on.
Okay, seriously, I mean, the animatronics were cute and all that, but if there's one thing I couldn't stand about the ride... Well, not that fox guy, but you know who I mean.
Oh god, please! Yucatan, don't start!
I had to listen to Mitsuru bitch and moan about all of the characters throughout the whole ride because they reminded her about a certain event involving minorities in some other country. She was yelling slurs nonstop at them relentlessly because she was a single queen that was severely traumatized and detestful of criminals with a darker complexion. God, do you know how fucking annoying that sounds? I would rather listen to the whole soundtrack of the ride instead of Mitsuru's fucking racist-ass bullshit.
Racist? How is she a racist?
Well, according to one of our many nights in Tartarus, I heard Mitsuru-san mention that destroying the shadows was just as fun as shooting minorities with a cap in their ass. These are her words, not mine.
No fucking way. Is this just because the shadows are all black when we first spot them? Is that what this is all about? Holy shit.
Is that the same reason why the other two Splash Mountains got closed down too? Damn, this is too much to take in when you think about it. Senpai would be laughing her ass off just thinking about it.
Sigh, I want to kill myself. Anyways, where's Akihiko-senpai and Mitsuru-senpai? They've been taking a long time to get changed already.
Hey guys, sorry I'm late. I had to help Shinji get used to putting on a new pair of clothes after he started shivering to death. Okay, that sounded like a bad joke. Shit, my bad.
Really funny, Aki. You just had to bring up my condition at this time. Jesus fucking Christ.
Oh, there you guys are. Do you know what's taking Mitsuru-senpai so long?
Well, actually, yes. She's trying out a new hairstyle look in the bathroom after the ride was done. I mean, she told me that she was relieved that this attraction full of minority-sounding animals was over. God, what a racist bitch. They don't even look that racist to me.
I wonder how many times Mitsuru's gonna go this far anytime she sees a shadow or, of course, a minority or criminal up close. Watch this, because I ain't capping. She's gonna yell out the racial slur against the shadows she literally fought for over 10 fucking years.
10 years, huh? Wow! Hey, by the way, Fuka and Ken are already at the store. Should we go now, Ai-chan?
Sure thing, Junpei-san. I'm ready whenever you are.
Okay, here's 50,000 yen. Don't spend it all on one place.
Thanks, dude. I'm very proud to say that you the man. All right, laters.
Huh, that Junpei. So nothing new yet?
No, not really. All we have to do is wait for Mitsuru to get out of the bathroom.
Yeah, we're trying to recover from all of the racist shit you just said earlier, bitch.
Me? A racist? Well, you thought wrong. Besides, I don't know what you're talking about. All I was focused on was the fact that my new C's armband model says number 0 on it. It should be number 1. But of course, Akihiko had to ask for it all because of your training. Yeah, I saw that you were enjoying the fact that you literally beat the shit out of those hoodlums at the shrine. Doesn't that make me any different from you?
We're not having this conversation again. Besides, I also have a knack for beating up anyone who shit talks about our fucking new game. So shut your ass up.
Hey guys, look at this.
Well, this was the last straw. If I can't get in Persona 3 Reload, then no one else can. Goodbye and get fucked, Atlas.
What the? Is that Kotone?
Ugh, of course she would do something like this.
Can't you show a little more remorse for once, Yukari?
What? I'm just stating the obvious. If she has some serious beef with Atlas, then I'd probably just have the same damn amount.
Oh, come on, Yukari. You were talking shit about that nonstop in the last video. We don't need a part two. Fuck. This is a part two video. Holy shit.
Whatever. This sounds like a real emergency if Kotone continues her rampage. Yuki, go gather the others and bring them all here. Then let's make our way out of the ghetto, trash, critter country land, and prepare for battle.
I am this close to fucking socking you in the face, Mitsuru. I am this close.
Same here, bro. Mitsuru's talking such cap.
Whatever, I don't care. Anyways, I'll meet you guys soon. Hey guys, I need to...
Wait, what are you doing?
Oh, Makoto-kun, what is it?
I found a good shirt for Ai-chan, by the way. I haven't spent any extra money on anything else, though, so you can relax.
Are you okay, Makoto-san?
You guys have to hurry up and pay. We have to cut our trip short and head back to the dorm.
What?
But we haven't explored the rest of the park yet. Not that I want to see it myself, but... yeah.
Well, okay. We'll hurry, Makoto-kun.
Good to know. All right, meet me back at the bridge. I'm gonna check on the others.
That does it!
What the fuck,
I have
you guys?
Had it up to here with you all calling me a racist bitch! How the fuck do you stanky-ass imbeciles dare treat me this way after all I've done for you?
That's bullshit. You know how long we had to hear you bitch and moan the whole time?
If it wasn't for Kodane, we would have gone on the ride a second time ourselves without you swearing up a fucking storm of slurs.
They're not slurs. They're just words about how I think of them in a different way. Oh my god, you two are nothing but oversensitive-ass snowflakes. To think you two were the backbone of C's, you're both actually pathetic as shit!
Oh, like how pathetic you acted yesterday about your new voice actor being better than yours. God, I really wonder which one of us is the real fucking imbecile here. Because clearly your ass
is- Guys! That is enough! Can you listen to me for one fucking moment? Please!
What?!
I got the others to hurry up soon. Can you guys chill out already?
Yeah, whatever.
Oh, here they come, finally!
Hey, dude, what's going on?
Nothing. Definitely no arguments here. Whatsoever.
Well, this was fun, at least. Mitsuru-senpai, do you know what's happening back home?
I'll have to explain it once we leave the park. Let's go, everyone!
I put the new Forgies on the Jeep. I drive them till the bloody bottoms are underneath.
Okay, first of all, you're not bawling. Jesus Christ.
Second of all, your car looked all banged up from the outside. Did you crash into anyone earlier ago?
Well, there was this one time.
Yeah, I think it's better that we don't know about what happened.
Sweet!
Guys, is it me? Or is she too happy all of a sudden?
She certainly is. It's scary, but somewhat strange at the same time.
I mean, getting your spotlight by forcing Atlas to give you a remake sounds cool and all. I think it sounds a little too much if you ask me.
Oh boy, I sure hope I didn't hear any lying bullshit in my car.
Oh, fuck me. I mean, sure, it's a good thing. Really is.
Just checking. Anyway, I hope nothing bad happens to us on the way to Atlas headquarters.
Katoshiomi, pull your car over right this instant or we'll shoot!
Oh hell no, it's the Fuzz!
What are you doing, Kotona?
I'm not going to prison for this. Time to go into maximum overdrive.
Ah shit! She got away! Shoot her!
Circle my tongue all around your tip. I said, shove down the dick so my tongue can drip. What the fuck?
How many more of these guys are going to show up? This makes no sense. It looks like I have no choice but to activate the car's super duper wacky, cracky, tabacky filled, ludicrous turbo speed.
Wait, what? Oh shit, 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 shit!
Hold on to your butts, everyone!
Damn it! She got away again!
Okay, is everyone all ready to go?
Hell fucking yeah! I'm ready to go!
Same here! Don't leave me out in this shit, dude! Codenay's gonna get what's coming to her!
I also brought my fair share of a gun as well. That way, no dirty slags or criminals will ever think about fucking with a single queen like me.
Holy fucking balls, Mitsuru! Who do you think you are, Queen Elizabeth?
If I may intrude...
Not now, Elizabeth. Anyways, I don't know if actual guns would be enough to shoot down Codenay or whatever, but I think we might be taking this a step too far if we're going to stop her. I mean, look at Aegis. She's the one with all of the guns, you know? Our melee weapons and evokers are enough.
That is right. My arsenal of weapons comes in a huge variety of possibilities for battle purposes only, as well as busting caps in my enemies' asses like Mitsuru-san said about shadows the other day.
Okay, Aegis. You know, you don't have to bring it up like that.
The only real weapons I'm taking into battle are my fists. These old reliable guys will fucking smash anyone in the jaw whenever fighting's involved. So I'd be more than happy to give Codenay the world star treatment that she deserves.
As for me, I'll give you all of the support that you need against Kotone-chan. I know it feels wrong to fight against our old friend, but we have no choice. We have to save Atlas from getting totally fucked over.
Not that we love Atlas or anything, but... yeah, Fuka's right. No way is my girlfriend, that pedophile's gonna kill the CEO like this. No fucking way!
There you go, Ken. Guess I wouldn't have to whoop your ass over your obsession with Codenay.
What the actual fuck?
Oh, shit. Hold on, dammit. I didn't actually say that I was going to beat him up. Because if I ever did, Ken would somehow find the most ridiculous way to corner me in a certain back alley to probably lash out at me and kill my ass with-
Okay, we don't need to hear any OG Persona 3 spoilers, Shinjiro-senpai. Holy fuck! What we need to do now is drive all the way to Atlas headquarters in Tokyo. And then we can stop Codenay once and for all. Some of us might die, some of us might not, and some of us might get our balls busted if Codenay starts attacking us guys first. But the main importance of this fight is that we all have to band together as one to win the day. You all willing to do this? You all ready to fight?
Yes!
Okay, then let's go.
We finally made it! It's time to take back what we were robbed of in the first place!
Look, Kotone, are you sure about this? We might all get totally fucked over by Atlas if things go south! Do you have any ideas or solutions to prevent this?
Yep! It'll be one that Atlas can't be able to stop! I'm going after their most secret weapon hidden in their vault! And I'll finally be able to get what I've wanted this whole time! Ha 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 ha! Maniacal laugh! To be continued in part 3!
Hasta la vista, Codenay bitch!
Oh, hell no. Look, everyone, I'm tired of being rejected by Atlas 24/7, so I think I should have a chance to get in the game as later DLC by myself. I don't want to be left in the dark like those other protagonists that they ignored literally just this year. Do you not realize what it's like to be in a secret vault at the headquarters of a well-known JRPG game company at all? I had everything! I had all of the potential of a new storyline, a chance in the spotlight, but then you guys all had to go and roast my ass about me being a pedophile for some reason because of Ken. So what? We're not dating. We're just friends. I just can't think of the actual reason why Atlas hates me. Do you guys hate me too?
Breaking news!
We've received numerous reports of Kodone Shiomi's recent rampage at an alarming rate, and it's much worse. Much, much worse. Nearly nobody was left alive when she was driving all the way to the Los Angeles airport to make her way to Japan. Now the CEO of Atlas at Sega Sammy headquarters is in trouble. Why do I have to say all of this? Well, I've had it up to here with Kodone Shiomi's shenanigans. I will conclude. Fuck you, Kodone.
Please stop me if I don't know it already. I believe that somewhere in the world is it Kotone Shiomi who started her vengeful conquest against the company?
Yes. That spoiled little bitch had the audacity to bring a rocket launcher out and blow up the building. Thank God for Sega lending us this place. We need to prepare for the worst if she makes her way over here.
There is no need to worry. Do not rush ahead, for I have a plan to get through her if your methods fail.
And what is that?
I'm going to have to tell you off-screen since I don't want the editors to use up their 11 labs quota. I went on a long tangent about the plan. Now then.
Well, there goes my precious screen time. You just harooed this bitch. Fuck me.
All right, Katone should be around here somewhere. Be on your guard.
Ha! I'm very relieved that the guards let us in with our weapons. That whole trick of telling them that they were special evokers totally worked.
Yeah, even if they're not the right size for this. Imagine if Mitsuru Senpai used a literal assault rifle as the inspirational model for our evokers. It would feel like we're riddling ourselves with bullets nonstop.
Meh, I guess that's just you worrying about it too much.
I'm not worried, Stupe. I just don't want to fall on my ass every time I have to summon my persona. And why do you sound so depressed all of the sudden?
What, me? I don't sound depressed, do I?
It's okay, Yukari-chan. Don't worry about it.
Wait, what the hell happened to your voice? Oh, never mind. Although I do like your sniper rifle, by the way. That's cute.
Thanks, Yukari-chan. Although I'm not physically strong enough to fight Kodone-chan with you all, but I can still give you all of the support I can with this reliable mofo right here. Kablam!
Well, it won't compare to these two guys I have right here.
Holy shit! I thought you were gonna use your fists, Akihiko-senpai!
I changed my mind. You guys are all gonna stick with guns while we all fight Kodone, yes? So it should be fair that I bring my own into this. I think this is better than beating up random punks and shadows everywhere I go in town, or in Tartarus itself.
You're still hell-bent on fighting, are you, Akihiko?
Yeah, no shit taken there, Mitsuru.
Whatever. As for me, my pistol will be enough. I already told you all why I use it.
So that you chase criminals away with it, we know.
I am the only one in the group with my wide arsenal of guns. I love all of your selections, though.
Yeah, thanks, Aichan!
Well, guys, if anything obviously happens to one of us, then I guess that means it was nice knowing you all.
What do you mean? You're not gonna die already, are you?
Believe me, Kotone could be hiding at any moment. She's gonna kill me first,
God
because...
God damn it, Shinjiro-senpai! You're not going to fucking die first! Holy shit!
Yeah, whatever. Sorry that I brought it up. Sheesh.
Wow, all of these posters here. Atlas sure does acknowledge the other game's existence in a way.
Yeah, even the answer game is still there. I honestly wonder if they'll ever remake it into DLC or something.
But don't some people hate the answer? Especially when you were acting like a total bitch, Kari.
Junpei, I fucking swear to God, don't you even start!
Sheesh! All right! Hold your bicorns there, Yucatan!
If I had a dollar every time Yukari was called that, then I'd already be filthy rich. Not that it matters anyway, or whatever.
Dude! You're the one with the unlimited amount of fucking yen from Tartarus, so don't even start! Mind if you spare me some?
Wait, I'm sensing someone. No, I sense three more individuals with Kodone-chan, I think.
Three individuals? Wait, hold on. Don't tell me that's Strega she's paired up with just now.
It's not Strega, it's... for some reason, they're persona users that we've never even heard of in the first place. I think they're getting near a secret vault.
Okay, Fuka. Concentrate on those four and give us the exact location.
All right, Yuki-kun, I'll give it my best.
Well then, it's finally come up to all of this. Time to give Kodone and the others the best fucking smackdown that they deserve. I mean, shoot down? Haha, yeah, that's what I meant.
Is it me, or am I the only sensible member of the group here?
Believe me, I feel you, man.
Jesus Christ.
That's literally just me.
I got it! They're hiding in the secret vault on the 13th floor of the building.
What?!
Seriously? Oh, come on! It's too late for this Halloween bullshit. It's November, I think.
Well, all of our messages up to this point were written on Halloween, so don't worry.
Oh, well, okay, you're correct.
Don't worry, Yukari-san. We have them right where we want them to be.
You're right, Aegis. Everyone, let's hurry.
Finally, at long last, it's the most prized item that Atlas refused to ever admit its existence to the public.
Kodane, not to interrupt you or anything, but you know that's just an Apple Watch Series 9, right?
No, it isn't. That's the Ultra Interdimensional Traveling Device 5000. You can go to any other dimension in the universe. And with that, I'm going to gather all of my variants to listen to my cause. Once that's done, then we'll overthrow the CEO of Atlas once and for all. And I'll be in charge of—
Kodane, stop!
There you are, Kodane. Drop the fucking watch right now. That shit doesn't belong to your stinky pink bum ass.
We won't let you win, Kodane.
Oh, thank God. We didn't want to be involved in this crap anyway.
Stop her, everyone. She's crazy.
Yeah, she's a bitch.
Fuck! You fucking fuck all of you! Hey, let go!
No, I won't!
Makoto!
No, Makoto-san!
Fuck!
Hey, Mitsuru-senpai! I got something for you!
What is it, Yukari? Is it finally some of that top-shelf Cali pack you promised?
Not this time. I already smoked all of it. It's actually this cheesecake that I baked for you. Here.
This cheesecake does look quite delicious, but something's up with the icing. The glossy white finish, the fishy chlorine smell. Is this semen?
No? The fuck? It's just vanilla icing. It's not cum, Mitsuru.
Sorry. That was a strange thing to ask. I trust you. The cream inside tastes like... The shit? This is fucking semen!
Oh, so you do know what semen tastes like. I always knew you was a whore!
Oh my God! Now this really does leave a bad taste in my mouth. Yukari, you stupid fucktard! You're not getting away with this, no matter how many times you say this is just a prank for a YouTube video. Wait, I know this taste. Is this from the staff of Gekkoukan High?
How in the ever-living fuck are you able to tell it's the cum from the teachers?
No, no, that's not the question here. The real question is how you were able to get the semen from every male teacher in Gekkoukan High. Don't tell me that you let them run a train in you while you collected all their cum in your pre-owned, shriveled-up pussy.
Shut the fuck up about my pussy being pre-owned and used. I don't know what type of shit you've had to do to become president of the student council, but I didn't do any of that because I actually respect myself and my body? Unlike you?
Oh? Then please enlighten me and how you were able to collect all that semen, because right now that's the only possible explanation.
Ever heard of a sperm donation? Of course not. You're too much of a pompous, stuck-up bitch to know anything about giving shit for free.
Despite what you think, Yukari, I'm not that retarded. I know what a sperm bank is, but that still doesn't change the fact you went on your knees to personally milk all the teachers for their baby nectar now with your own hands, doesn't it?
Okay, you asked for it. Mitsuru, you stupid fucking lying-ass stereotypical know-it-all rich-ass sorry excuse for a student council president. You better take your raggedy whack-ass cum-flavored cheesecake with you tomorrow at school and eat it like you were eating Mrs. Canoe's wide-ass pussy in the faculty office while that milk-hunting virgin fucking cries in the background since he can't grab a slice of it. Oh, and just because you're against a polyamorous relationship that Makoto has with the four of us doesn't give you the fucking right to be a goddamn hypocrite just lying straight out of your ass. Yeah, how does that sound, you dumbass bitch? I can't wait to announce to the whole school tomorrow that you're officially the whore of Gekkoukan High. I can already see Hollywood taking notes on this shit, and they'll... Gah! What the...
Oh, hey there. Is this a bad time?
Just give me the fucking watch, Kodane. I won't let you... Ow!
Ha! Get fucked, Makoto! See you never!
Now, what the fuck was that about? Oh, yeah. Where was I?
Hey there! It's me, so don't freak out, please.
Huh? What? Are you... Me?
Finally! Now I won't die a virgin!
Yeah, it is what it looks like.
I'm you from another universe, and I need your help.
On one condition. You help me groom minors online. Do you agree?
Yes.
Goody! Now tell me the plan, me!
Okay, I don't have a lot of time, so you might want to hear the shorter version of my plan, so...
Kodane, do you realize what you've unleashed? Don't fucking talk to her!
Aw, shit! If it isn't Makoto, the emo boy with unspoken riz, you really think you can stop me from achieving my goals? I'm always two steps ahead like a certain fat ass who's killing himself for views.
And what about my goals, too? I'm just waiting around here for a cupcake, really?
You have to stop, Kotone. Have you learned nothing from what I told you last time?
Kotone, I don't know what to say.
What I can say is that you're... Look, whatever you did out there, if you're doing what I think you're doing, then it's not gonna work. Kotone, please. I know how badly you want to get into the remake, but I don't think that'll happen yet until Atlas actually decides to make you playable in a full DLC story pack. So can you please patiently wait until they decide to do that? And if you ever get a new voice actress, I hope she also sounds as good as the original. Just give it time. Or do whatever you want, I guess. I don't care, really.
So does that mean
Just get the fuck out of here already. We'll see you whenever. Sheesh.
Fuck! You fucking fuck all of you! Yes, I remember it clearly through every word. What you told me has motivated me further. You told me to get the fuck out of the dorm. That was your own damn fault, you pussy.
Okay, Kodane. You're not British, all right? Second of all, I'm gonna kick your ass.
Persona!
Wow, you fucking suck, Makoto!
Oh, fucking the fuck! Get back here!
Hey there! Would you want to get out of IG's and join me on a very important quest? Goody! Now let's go!
Holy crap! Groomer female main character from Persona 3!
Hi, Peter. Atlas wants you to forget that I dated a 10-year-old boy.
Put your hands up!
Hey there! You want me to get you out of here before the SWAT team decides to wanton your ass? Sure thing. Get me the fuck out of here. Nice. Now then, this will take a moment.
Wait a minute. Where's the suspect? Wait, where did she go? Wait a minute. There she is!
Die, die, die!
Oh my god!
Get fucked, SWAT team! Hey there! Would you like to change the thongs 2 times a day while you help me on my quest?
Okay.
Okay, I'll make sure that you're tight as a virgin, so don't get nervous.
Okay.
Kotone, are you okay?
Pa, please, mister, not this to time again!
Huh, who's mister?
Businessman, not this to time. Okay?
Hey, I'm not that mister that you're referring to. I'm Junpei, remember? We used to be together back then. Whoa, what the shit?
Hey there, would you like to get out of this shithole of a jail?
Yes, please.
What the, is that another Kotone?
Hey, don't touch her!
Haha, get fucked, you guys. This was fun, but I have to go now. See you never.
She'll bring her back eventually. Maybe she's having some crazy girls' night out or something.
Curse all you
motherfucker!
I have enough mies to band together with me so I can get my revenge on Atlas once and for all. But I might actually need more of myself.
Where are we? Wait, what is this place? What?
You know, Makoto, it's funny, really.
I always feel so alone whenever I see you hanging out with your friends. Remember when you kicked me out of the dorm while you guys went to Splash Mountain?
Yeah, that was a total dick move.
You guys are nothing but jerks. All this time, you've treated me like nothing but trash since the internet exploded over my social link with Ken. Now I feel like a total outcast aside from those worthless ass protagonists.
I told you. I fucking told you. I had everything. But then everyone started calling me all of these awful names. Anytime I walked down the street, I got called EDP445. Or I would be called non-canon, pedophile, kitty diddler, and a gender-swapped Mary Sue protagonist with no dick. Do you not know how it feels to be discriminated by everyone aside from Atlas themselves? Do you not realize how many times I got fucked over?
The fans worship you. They worship that so-called Chad protagonist from Persona 4. They also bust a nut every time they see Joker from Persona 5 and vice versa. They don't care about me anymore. And for what?
Is it because I'm voiced by Laura Bailey? Or is it the fact that they know that I like touching kids? You know what? Fuck this. Fuck all of it to hell. All that's old shit.
Are you seriously referencing GTA San Andreas right now?
Shut the fuck up, Makoto. I made it. I'm a success. I can't be touched. And now, after I told you everything from the bottom of my heart, here's what I'm going to do now. I'll travel to every single universe, bring a variant of myself here, and then build up my entire army of me's to take over Atlas. And additionally, if you don't get the fuck out of my way, then I will kill you all. One by one.
Kodone. I'm sorry, I can't let you do that. You've gone way too far. This ends now.
Huh?
Haha, you shoot like a pussy.
What? No, that was you moving out of the fucking way, you cheater.
Well, too bad. I have plot armor, so the editor of the video has to keep me alive for another part of this series. So that means you can't stop me.
Fuck!
Well, I guess I better send you back before we waste any more quota. Not like that matters, since we'll use the rest for part 4. So, goodbye!
Ow, guys.
Dude, where were you? And where the hell is Kodone?
Do you have any idea where she went? How come you're back here already?
Hold on a second, you guys. Kodone wouldn't normally do this. Don't tell me.
I believe it's possible that Kotone-san is... She's going to fulfill her mission. And if we can't stop her, then... Then all is lost.
Oh, fuck. So much for us bringing the big guns.
Yeah, we're totally screwed, Ken.
Makoto-kun? Hey, Makoto-kun? Are you okay? Can you hear me? Makoto-kun, please.
Holy Jesus, getting whipped relentlessly by the Romans. This is totally such cap, all right.
My fellow Kotones, we are gathered here today to discuss a very important issue. Atlas, the greedy, ignorant Persona 5 milking company, has totally fucked all of us over. Each of us want the same thing, and what is that?
We want to be in Persona 3 Reload!
Yes, that's the kind of enthusiasm we all need right now.
We're finally going to make Persona 3 Reload an anime gacha game. Now I can finally DM all the little gullible kids I want. And we're gonna throw everyone else involved with Atlas's bullshit in prison. We'll see how they'll like it.
Now I shall call ourselves all of us present here today. We are now known as the Kodone Regime.
Greetings, I am iGuess. You have reached the end of the video and have possibly endured the crazy nonsensical wave of shenanigans of part 3. Now it is time to sponsor one of Makoto-san's latest favorite games of all time, which is Marvel's Spider-Man 2. Marvel's Spider-Man 2 is a single-player open-world superhero video game that stars both Peter Parker and Miles Morales, the two Spider-Men who have sworn themselves to protect New York City from a wave of new villains and even older ones, such as Kraven the Hunter, Sandman, Mr. Negative, Lizard, and finally, Venom. The game has exciting forms of new combat skills for both Spider-Men, as Peter has a wide variety of skills to choose from, while Miles has his unique abilities returning from his standalone game. The map of New York City has also been doubled. You can now visit Queens, Brooklyn, and other places on the right side after not being able to access it for over 5 years of waiting. Oh, and everyone's favorite waifus are back in action, such as Mary Jane Watson, Black Cat, Yuri Watanabe, or otherwise known as Wraith, and even Haley also returns in the game as well. There are so many other exciting things that you can do in the game, so why not download it today? It really varies depending whenever you want to spend $70 or $80 on this masterpiece and...
I guess shut the fuck up!
Well, it appears that the annoying bitch Kari has called for me again to stop. I guess I'll end the sponsor here, so don't forget to buy it. Also, make sure to like and subscribe on this video and channel. Goodbye!
Huh? You kids?
Mr. CEO, we have to get you out of here and fast.
Yeah, we're not letting Katoni kill your ass on the spot, man!
Oh, thank God. You kids have to get me out of here before my life becomes obviously threatened in an untimely situation like this.
Why are you suddenly jinxing it?
Yeah, no time to talk this over. We'll take the emergency exit to the right. Come on.
Guys, I have a bad feeling about this.
Oh, what now? This isn't a Star Wars reference, Shinjiro Senpai. Jesus Christ!
Surprise, did you guys miss me?
Oh fuck, it's Katoni again!
You're damn right, you 11 Turbo V2 using jerks! I want you to meet all of my friends, especially Swimsuit Katoni, yet I... excuse me? It's Crisis of the Multiverse Katoni, Mistress Katoni. Also, click on the Discord link below to join the creator's server to follow in more on my storyline. Do it now! Yeah, anyways, ooh, look at that! Character filler!
Oh shit, such cap!
Shinjiro-senpai!
Araki! Shinjiro-san!
Shinji-senpai!
Shinjiro!
No, Shinji!
See? Now I just have to deal with the rest of you! Get fucked, you non-canon extremists!
Katoni, don't do this!
Nope! No more rematches, you emo fucktard! Wow, this is getting easier by the day! Now then! You're going to be doing me a lot of favors. There is no escape. You are surrounded, you damn dirty pig.
Ugh, I knew something like this would happen. Fine then. I surrender.
The year is 2025. It is a cold Christmas. Japan is not the same as it was. Kodane Shiomi and her army Kodane invaded the country and took it by force. As of December 2025, it is now known as Jatone. Sounds like a really stupid name, but yeah. Every street, intersection, city, and whatnot is all named after Kodan. She made our country into a total dictatorship rule. Not North Korea, for God's sake, but yeah, near future-ish shit. Persona 3 Reload has been re-released so many times with Kodane in it, and countless spin-offs have her featured as the main character, including one where she replaces every single character in the game. Oh, and all the other people that have jobs now are reduced peasants without jobs. The Kodanes took over and now have these jobs. Teachers, maids, construction workers, news reporters, chefs, rice farmers, you name it. We live in a Kodane society, and I think there's no way to stop it.
Katoni. I am your host, Katoni, and here is my co-host, Katoni. Oh, thank you, Katoni. Now then, let's cover the news. Katoni Duck Burger's stocks have been soaring high lately, as well as Hagatoni with its extreme boost of popularity in the select ramen choices. Moving right along,
it's revealed that the extremely well-known actress Kotone Shiomi has been caught in an affair with her wife, Kotone Shiomi, while cheating on her with an alleged prostitute, Kotone Shiomi.
Wow, that's a lot of romantical Kotone drama. Now let's move on to the next set of news.
Hey, are you okay? You've been watching TV all day. What's wrong?
It's nothing.
So? There's more things to do out there now that... Well, you know... Look, I gotta go do my homework. Can you help me out with it?
No, not really. I don't care.
Oh well. I'll work on it myself.
Two days ago, everything appeared to be fairly normal. That was, until Kotone came along. Then, just yesterday, as we were trying to fight her. We failed.
We all did. After what she did to us, to Shinji. I don't want to just sit here and do nothing about it. We have to stop her, somehow. I want to make a promise to you all. I'll keep fighting until I collapse. I can't hold this burden anymore.
Are you serious? None of us want to lose this fight either, Akihiko-senpai. We have to try our best. Living here in fear while not doing anything about it is like running away from the fight.
Yeah, same. I wouldn't know what I'd be doing instead of fighting right now. In fact, I don't even know where I'll be at if I haven't met all of you.
We're all here for a reason, Junpei-kun. I wanted the power to protect everyone, and I still want to stay connected with others. If we don't win this fight, then...
Then we all die.
I don't really care. Are you all that afraid of dying?
Huh? What are you saying?
It's very simple, Yukari. Then again?
What? Dude, you just can't bail out of this!
Guys, you don't understand. Kotone is way too powerful. No matter how hard I tried to stop her, she always turned the tables around.
Damn it, Makoto, what is wrong with you? Why are you acting like this?
You were dedicated to stopping Kotone in the first place! You can't give up now!
I don't give a shit, really. We're done. As of today, we're no longer teammates. Seize is officially disbanded.
You son of a-
What the hell do you want us to do then? We have to beat her up without you taking command.
So what do you propose? A suicide mission? We're nothing without our leader, Akihiko-senpai.
I don't want any of us to lose this fight. Must you all keep fighting with each other instead of against the real enemy here?
You're right, I guess. How can we keep arguing like this forever? We have to try
and- Forget it.
Makoto-san.
Hey there, Makoto. Long time no see.
Yeah, I know this isn't the best time for me to show up like this, but I do need to talk to you about something important.
Ryoji? Oh well, come in.
Thanks, Makoto. Say, not to be rude, but where is everybody? Are the girls busy by themselves as always?
Before you start jocking up my style of getting a harem of girls, I can say this. Yes, they are. Yukari's a movie star, and in college. Mitsuru's in charge of this team called the Shadow Operatives. Fuka's also in college with a science scholarship she's taking now. Aigis is with the Shadow Operatives. Akihiko wants to become a police officer so he can be the snot out of criminals on the streets like fucking always. Junpei is a baseball coach, and Ken is in middle school. Oh, I almost forgot. And Koromaru's with him too.
And what are you doing here by yourself?
Well, I'm being a total slob. I can't get off of my ass while watching a full run of Breaking Bad reruns.
I see. Hey, you know that you and I are literally alike, so you can tell me anything you want.
Are you sure you want to know?
Yes, I do. You can tell me.
Oh well, you're not going to like this. Turns out, I lied. We actually went to Splash Mountain in Tokyo Disneyland instead after assuming that this was one huge prank. Then, I pulled up my phone and saw the news of her previous rampage. She blew up the Atlas West headquarters the same time we were at the dorm. She then got roasted by us when I made fun of her tattoos. But Kotone snapped and went on this long rant about why she was excluded from Persona 3 Reload. I told her to get the fuck out of here and that we would see her later. Then we found out that Kotone stole an Apple Watch that seemed to be a dimensional traveling device, and I had to follow her in. She gathered up so many Kotones from different universes to build up her army, and I failed constantly because she said some bullshit about plot armor or something. And after I fell on my backside and sort of broke it, Katoni arrived in the office and blew up Shinjiro to smithereens. Then, she blew us all out of the building while we fell into a lake. Katoni won. And for 2 years, Japan was never the same again. I mean, to be honest, Atlas was never the same again. You know? Just look at the company right now! They're remaking Persona 3 Reload so many times with the new voice actors, as well as including Katoni in all of the spin-offs. Now she's the new face of Atlas. Anything that was related to Persona 5 was entirely scrapped because Katoni is now the CEO of the company. Not that I don't like Persona 5 getting milked a lot, but she did one thing that was totally unforgivable. Do you know the anticipated game Persona 6?
No. What is it that she did?
She fucking pandered the shit out of it! Apparently, she allowed mods to have her female root have every social link in the game to be dateable regardless of age, gender, and species. Especially the older adults in the game that are literally older than her. And dating Koromaru is apparently fucking possible! Wait a minute. I may have been referring to that bazillionth remake of Persona 3, but that's beside the point. But the worst thing she did in the game was character customization.
We don't need that!
The Persona franchise was fine without a customizable character. It didn't need any fucking pandering bullcrap in the first place. Because nowadays I hear her say,
"Put a chick in it and make her gay and lame!"
But Mistress Katoni, our stock revenue will drop by.
I don't give a flying fuck! Make her gay and lame! We're South Parking this shit!
Whoa, this conversation had escalated very fast. All this over a video game?
Yes, that, and she's a pedophile grooming Ken.
Wait, what the fuck did you just say?
Katoni loves 10-year-olds. Little boys like Ken. Doesn't that ring a bell?
Are you shitting me?
I'm literally 10 years old too, but I don't look like it to her in some dumbass perspective of hers. Didn't you forget that I was a fucking 10-year-old child literally trapped in your body?
No, I didn't forget, Ryoji.
You know what? To hell with the flirting bullshit. You need to get your emo bum ass off of that raggedy whack-ass couch and gather all of your friends that should be helping you in the first place.
Who cares? It's pointless.
I do care. It's pointless, my ass. We need to bring an end to all of this. I can literally just turn into your useless Death Arcana crap persona that you barely use and just send her ass to the ground. You're gonna need me, Makoto.
I fucking hate my life. All right. But we need to wait for Ken to finish his homework first, then we can go gather the rest.
Wow. No wonder why you've been lying around on your ass all day. Ugh, fine. I've been wanting to play that game that came out 2 years ago. Baldur's Gate 3, was it?
Don't.
Man, I'm bored. Hey, Petatoni, what's the revenue for Persona 3 Reload Impact Star Rail Definite FEMSI Edition Remastered?
Over $340 billion so far!
All of the adult players are having a great time dating minors and older people without any limits, like me!
Ken is so adorable and gullible to be my boyfriend. Okay. You know, this whole CEO thing's getting pretty old for me all of a sudden. I mean, I already had the older CEO of Atlas turned into my personal bodyguard slave. All right, we're going to go over this one more time. From now on, every game that we make has to have a chick who is gay and lame. The Snowflake mob loves that shit.
But what about the male characters?
They can all be fucking lame too! We have to totally de-characterize every single male character in our games so that our strong, diverse female characters can either be the socially awkward type of girls or very independently stunning and brave girls like Abby from The Last of Us Part 2. 10 out of 10 game.
What in the actual heavenly pink juggling balls is wrong with you? Do you suddenly hate all men now?
Oh my god! Did you just talk back to me, you patriarchal misogynist?
I mean...
You want me to show you what happens the next time you want to lie in front of my face with all of that totally untrue bullshit you're spouting on my face? If you are, then I'll have no choice but to literally tear you limb by limb and kill you nonstop and resurrect you and make you experience it all over again.
Isn't that right, Mr. Former CEO?
No! Oh, good God, spare my life, Queen! I'll do anything. I'll lick your white girl female protagonist feet if you want. Just don't torture me forever and ever!
There we go. I knew you were such a pussy. That will teach your sorry ass a lesson, you pig. Now then, for your punishment, I want you to work with the team downstairs and start overseeing the process of the next game in development. And if you don't, you're gonna have to lick Cupcake's feet and Benson's balls.
Katoni guards, take him away!
Yes, Mistress Katoni!
There we go. Now that serves him right.
Hmm.
What? What in the total ass crack is this? Why do I feel so bored?
Like some certain antagonist detective who was living in a society because he couldn't get any bussy in life. I mean, what else is there to do nowadays? How the hell do I pull through? Hey, Alt Katoni, what are you up to?
That to work, you palabins! If you want me to snatch your flocking pheasant faces in, do you?
Yes, please, Miss Shishiomi, don't hurt us, no more!
Then quit the bullshit and get back to work! Now, hey there, President Shiomi! Quite the long face you got there, huh? Tell you what, I'm in the middle of something right now. Looks like these slikers are slowing us down with some delays. We don't want that, do we?
No.
Good! Now keep working!
Okay, then.
Hey, Mitsuru-senpai. Long time no see.
Makoto? What brings you here?
This is going to sound crazy, but you're going to want to hear this. I realized that I was an asshole, and I'm so sorry for that. If you don't think I am, well, that's fine. But I don't want to not contribute to anything and let you guys carry your burdens by yourselves. What was really important to me was that I needed my friends. You all had successful lives over the last 2 years, and I was just a lazy slob who did nothing but spend all of my time alone, shopping at Hot Topic and listening to depressing emo music, or basically the original Persona 3 soundtrack, to be honest. But that isn't relevant now. The most important thing is that I can't stand Katoni's bullcrap anymore. Every single game she releases becomes worse over time, and if she keeps milking it, then we'll all be forgotten. And all of Japan will just see Katoni as a household name and a so-called iconic queen like those two women that TikTokers make remixes out of them a lot. So to hell with giving up. We need to take a stand, and we have to do it right now. So, are you with me?
So, we can now place our trust in you?
Yes, believe me. I won't let you guys down ever again. I know we can do this. And with all of us reunited together, there is no way we'll ever lose. We can stop Katoni once and for all, and if there's a chance, we can undo all of the damage that was done to our country.
Very well. Now then, Makoto, bring everyone back over to the dorm. It's about time that we started taking more action.
So, everyone, how have you all been? Okay, look. I know some of you are mad at me for what I said back then. But this is not the case. Just tell me one by one, each and every one of you, ask me how do you feel about Atlas right now?
It's lame.
And you know what? Yeah, I can agree with her. It was definitely a lot worse than the other games that came out way back then. Atlas wasn't as fun when Katoni came in power.
The more I hear about Atlas, the more annoying changes are made to each game whenever Katoni wanted to try something new. I mean, seriously. Look at Persona 4 Arena Ultimax Katoni Shiomi Portable Remastered Definitive Edition. She totally made herself the main character and became a total Mary Sue to defeat that god of lies and destruction, or whatever. It's just so damn lazy.
To think I would once become well known for my death battle victory just because of that game. Now the channel was forced to include Katoni in the series and have her win every fight against her opponent. It's unfair. Yet at the same time, it was very demanding from her.
I also saw that every single character aside from Katoni-chan was replaced with Katoni. I know there were bad self-insert characters before, but now I understand why Katoni did that for her games.
And don't get me started on the whole grooming minors crap. Or even worse, the whole gimmick of dating adults being apparently a more common thing now in Katoni's new Persona games. It makes completely no sense.
And all of the sudden, everyone is okay with this? God, they're not in their right mind! I mean, what happened to our country?
I think we already know the reason why, Yukari. Katoni happened.
So, does this mean we finally get the big guns and shoot her down?
Hey, Makoto? Can I ask you something really quick?
Yes?
Since when have your friends become totally deranged?
I don't know. I'm not completely in charge of their tactics. I'm not in control of their everyday lives. So, I don't know what to say about this.
I would say that...
that I'm going to beat the ever-living fuck shit out of Katoni for everything she's done to you in your crazy-ass country. Ooh! I'll cast Hameon on her ass and she'll be weak to it. That's what the fuck I'll do to her!
Whoa! Calm the fuck down, Ryoji! Jesus!
Wait, that's literally me again, right?
Phew, there we go. I finally vented out my frustrations. Now, I guess we're all good to go.
I almost can't believe that we are fighting side by side again with you, Ryoji-san. Although for a time, I once believed that you were dangerous. Now I know who we are really dealing with. Kotoni-san must be stopped no matter what.
And she will. As long as we're together, we'll stop her and her variants. But there's another thing. We need to steal back that Apple Watch dimensional traveling device that she used 2 years back. I think, when we were getting closer to her in that vault, I heard something about time travel.
This is why I don't like time travel movies. But what do you propose to do with it, Makoto-kun?
I have to use it to go back. Back to the very beginning before Katoni suddenly showed up and started her vengeful conquest. But if that happens, then...
then our memories will all be erased. We will forget everything before she started all of this. And we will forget each other.
So why not make a promise or something? You guys did that before in the original game, right? Because it was your bonds that prevented your memories of each other from really going away. I feel like this should be the easiest thing to do so that you guys won't forget all of the experience you had together. Even if I wasn't present to be with you all back then, I still do understand that you have your every reason for doing this. Stopping Katoni for screwing up Atlas just because she wasn't included in the remake may sound reasonable, but...
but it's the only way we can do it.
I don't see any other option, man. We gotta try.
Well then, you call the shots, leader. We're going out there to stop her after we're finished with a morally long tangent about stopping Katoni. But not just that. We're doing this for Shinji as well. I think he deserves more than just crappy-ass remakes and remasters being thrown out of Katoni's hands every 1 or 2 years. So I say, we really fight her and her army until the very end. Let's do our best.
You're right, Akihiko-senpai. Let's make the most out of this together.
I'll back you all up however I can. I'll push myself over the limit if I have to.
It's about time we show her who the real bitch is, because she's a bitch Toni!
Oh yes, you're right! Bitch Toni! Bitch Toni!
Yeah man, bitch Toni!
She's nothing but a bitch Toni.
Haha, bitch Toni!
Now we have something new to milk, and I won't regret any second of this. Bitch Toni!
Sounds like you guys are milking it already. But that's okay. Bitch Toni!
Anyways, now that we went on a total bitch Toni streak, I guess we should get ready to prepare for battle once again. Now, who's with me?
We are!
Okay, then let's hop to it.
And so it begins.
Got
Sir, is it time?
Yes. They haven't found the other hidden vault yet. Those dumbass non-canon bitches. We technically lost the war, but after so much agonizing work, we found this.
Do you remember the password, sir? It's been 2 years since...
Yes, I know. I clearly memorized it by heart. And luckily, it's no ordinary password. It is. Crisis of the Multiverse is broke as shit.
Password valid. Access granted. Welcome, Mr. Atlas West, CEO.
Remind me to fix her voice modulator later. It has been 22 years since we started working on this secret project. Not even the Cotonis have found it yet. I've been waiting for a long time to use this just in case our company went downhill. Say, do you know what this is? Random employee?
Oh my god, that's the most dangerous project of them all. I thought it wasn't true, but now what? It's right before our eyes.
But it is the only key to reclaiming what we've lost. This power has the ability to create or destroy anything the user desires. And despite what it will do to you, or me, or anyone who ever takes a hold of it, will be granted this power.
God have mercy on us. This is why the damn thing it's called. Project Demon.
What now?
Well, I can say this, Atlas CEO. This has been quite the war on Atlas, am I right? Right? Ha ha ha.
Right. Well, if there ever happens to be a movie that follows up to this series, then so be it. I want to get more of the spotlight as much as possible.